Well, a fantastic win 2 weeks ago to come from behind. How's it been, and have you taken the confidence from that over these last 2 weeks?
Yeah, I hope so. It's always nice to go into an international break winning, because it becomes a long 2 weeks. Obviously, if you don't manage that, so the turnaround and fortunes in the game was excellent. The boys' attitude and desire and spirit that we constantly speak about was there in abundance. So it just makes life a bit easier when you're building up and you've no got the game to play for the following week, and you're no sitting on that and a defeat and wallowing in that for too long. So it was important we got that win, and in the manner we did made it all the better.
How are you looking injury-wise? 2 weeks for boys to recover. How is everyone?
Yeah, we're all good. Just the long-term ones. McGuinness, Lyons. Brad is back on the pitch, which is good to see, but it's still a bit too early to get him back involved. But it's excellent to see him back involved and running and getting a wee touch of the ball to the latter end of the week as well, which is pleasing for us.
Matty Kennedy?
Matty's fine. He's obviously been fine with the time scale and the time to recover. He's all good to go again as well.
What's the message been over this 2 week period? You know, you've got 3 games until the split. Everyone knows what the aim is. What's the message been to the players?
The message hasn't changed really in the last month or so. The aim is to try and cement this place in the top six. We've still got a bit of work to do, obviously. We're in the strongest position as it stands, and it's up to ourselves to make the most of the position we're in, and we'll strive to do that. That's important to that, really, for us. It's always been the aim. Constant improvements within the group, and obviously we've managed that up to now, and it would be nice just to see the job through, and the sooner we do that, the better. Obviously, it saves any tension as the games roll on.
Yeah, obviously you say sooner the better. You could do it this weekend with a victory. I take it that's the aim, you want to get it over the line as soon as you can?
Yeah. Listen, we know how difficult it will be going away from home. Tynecastle, our games over the last couple of seasons have been predominantly tight games, nothing between the two teams. I think since the last time we met between the 2 years, we've only lost 3 games, both teams. So we know consistently both teams have been good. Their form's been excellent, so we know how difficult it will be, but the aim is obviously to get there as soon as we can, and if that happens tomorrow, that would be brilliant for us as a group to achieve that.
To go back to the St Mirren game quickly, that second half performance felt like a real statement. What did you as a management team do or say to the boys at half time to elicit that reaction?
The manager was actually quite calm. I think the boys have said he was a bit highly strung. I actually didn't think he was. He was quite calm in his demeanour. I think the players knew their cell that they had to give a lot more, and I think they took a lot of ownership of that situation, which again is credit to them. And I think they just knew that firstly it couldn't have got much worse than it was in the first half, and they had a point to prove to themselves, and through hard work and the momentum, the shift in the momentum came pretty quick in the second half, and once we got the first goal, they thrived off of that momentum, and obviously to get 5 goals in any game, but to do it in the period of time we did was an exceptional 20-minute performance really at that stage of the game.
And is that second half now the benchmark for these 3 games going into the split?
Yeah, you'd love to set that benchmark. We're full of realisation that it doesn't always work that way, and the shift in momentum, St Mirren just couldn't get to grips with the game at that stage, and it's no something that happens to them as a team very often. So from our point of view, to achieve it against them was outstanding for us. But our benchmark doesn't change. We still have to be a hard-working, disciplined team and work hard together as a group, which we tend to do more often than not as a team.
And from you on a personal level, how have you found this role change from summer till now, and have things gone better than you could have expected when you looked at the squad back in June?
The improvement's been pretty vast really in terms of where we've came from last season. I think it was a tough season, the manager spoke about that, how difficult it was, but again the aim was to keep the club in the division. We managed that, and it was from then on the importance to see improvement. But I think we've seen that, with the greatest of respect to last season's squad, we've seen that within the group, that there's improvement within the group of players, and that's credit again to the manager and Ross Richardson, head of recruitment, in terms of how they go about the recruitment and the type of players they bring into their football club. So from my point of view, I kind of speak too much about that. Obviously, that's them that get their heads together and work towards that as quickly as possible and see when they can review the squad. And obviously, that's worked up to now with the players they brought in pre-season.
And is there any talk amongst the players or the management team about Europe? Do you allow yourself to look at that at all, or is it all about securing top six before there's any sort of conversation about that?
Pretty much. It's just top six. If we can get ourselves in amongst top six, granted as tough as those games will be against that opposition within the top six, you're going to, the way the league table is just now, you're going to have an opportunity to be giving yourself a shot to get into Europe. So we'll have to aim to do that first and foremost, and then if we can get to Europe, it would be incredible. But like I say, firstly, we need to try and cement that top six place.
And I think the next two teams you play are two of the three teams you haven't beaten the league this season. You've beaten everybody else. Psychologically, how important could that be going into the split if you can get victories over Hearts and Roskenny?
I think obviously the Hearts one's a big one because you'll then play them again within the top six. The County one, depending on the result tomorrow, becomes a bigger game. It's old... you've got to then think about next week. If you don't win tomorrow, it becomes a wee bit more pressure on that game. So we'll take it one game at a time. I know it's a bit cliched, but first and foremost, we'll go to Tynecastle, see how that game pans out, and then we'll think about Ross County after that.